Hello everybody, today we are going to see some more problems which are depend on the concept triangle. Okay, already we have seen some conditions of congruency. Okay, so this is again we are going to see here theorem. The statement is given here, that is, if the bisector of a vertical angle of a triangle bisects the base of the triangle, then the triangle is isosceles. Okay, figure is also given. Once again I am reading here, statement C, if the bisector of a vertical angle of a triangle, here triangle ABC is given and vertical angle is A. Okay, bisector of vertical angle, they have told us, means AD is here, AD is bisector, means here this angle BAD and CAD is equal. Okay, AD is the bisector of angle A, that means angle BAD and CAD are equal. Okay, and what is given? C bisects the base of the triangle, bisects the base of the triangle, this is the BC is the base of the triangle, and this bisector AD bisects base also. So here we can say BD and DC are equal, BD and DC are equal. So that is given. Okay, so first, as usual, we need to write given things. What is given? Okay, what is given in triangle ABC? In triangle ABC, what is given? AD is the bisector. AD is the bisector of angle A. Of angle A, also, and meeting, and AD meeting at point D. At point D on BC. So BD is equals to CD, that is also given. Okay, what is given? This is the bisector, so these two angles BAD and CAD are equal. Okay, so here if you want, you can mention that also, angle BAD is equals to angle CAD. Okay, so this is given things. These are the given things. Now we are going to write to prove. To prove what we are going to prove, then the triangle is isosceles. What they are asking, we have to prove triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle. So here triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle. Triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle, that we have to prove. Okay, so now if you see here figure, isosceles triangle means what we need to prove here? AB is equals to AC. AB is equals to AC. Okay, if AB and AC are equal, then we can say triangle ABC is isosceles triangle, because isosceles triangle means what? Any two sides are equal. Okay, so for that we need to prove here triangles are congruent. But in the given situation, what is given here? These two angles are equal. Okay, AD is the common side and BD and DC are equal. Okay, so suppose I am going to use here in this position, if I am going to use any criterion which we have learned, so directly we cannot use here, because here see angle side, and they didn't told us these two angles are equal, so we cannot use here angle side angle. Okay, side is given. Okay, here angle, this side and this side. Okay, means they are not connected to each other, so directly here we cannot use any criteria. Okay, directly we cannot use, so we need to do some constructions. Okay, so what we are going to do here, see, we have to produce AD in such a way AD is equals to D. Suppose we are going to take that point E here. Okay, so AD, whatever length of AD, so same length we will produce from point D. So I am doing with dotted lines. Okay, so produce AD and join C okay, so this point I am saying here E. Okay, so this is point D. So we need to do here construction. So now after construction, what we are going to see, how we are going to prove triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle, that we will have discussion and then we will bring on the paper. Okay, so see, after construction you will get here three triangles. Okay, when you will produce AD till point E in such a way AD is equal to ED, means this is, these two are equal, AD is equals to DE, okay, by construction. Then we have taken this join EC, okay, so that I am taking here construction. Construction, okay, produce AD to E such that AD is equals to DE, AD is equals to DE or ED, okay, and then join CE, okay. Now see, after construction you will have three triangles, this is this one and this one, three triangles. But from that, suppose I am thinking about triangle ADB and triangle EDC, we are able to prove both the triangles are congruent, okay. See, AD is equals to DE, why, what is the reason, by construction. Then these two are vertically opposite angle, so vertically opposite angles are always equal, and BD is equals to CD, which is given. So by side angle side, both the triangles are congruent, okay, triangles are congruent. If triangles are congruent, we are talking about this and this triangle, if both the triangles are congruent, then we can say this angle, means angle BAD is equals to CED by CPCT, corresponding parts of congruent triangle. BAD, this angle, and angle this angle is equal by CPCT, because already we have given proof both the triangles are congruent by SAS criteria. So this angle and this angle is equal, okay. Also we can say AB is equals to CE, AB is equals to C. Just now I told you this angle and this angle is equal, okay, but they have told us this angle and this angle is also equal, that is given, because AD is the bisector, understood. First I told you angle BAD is equals to CED, but BAD is equals to CAD also, means we can say CAD is equals to CED, okay. So triangle ACE is isosceles triangle, triangle ACE is isosceles triangle, because base angles are equal. If base angles are equal, then we can say CE is equals to AC, CE is equals to AC, understood. But CE is equals to AB also, so we can say in short AB and AC are equal, so that is our proof, okay. So we will bring on the paper, see carefully, proof, okay. First, after construction in triangle ADB and triangle EDC, okay, we have which things we have, AD is equals to ED, AD is equals to ED, why, by construction, accordingly we have done construction, okay. Then we can say angle ADB is equals to EDC, angle ADB is equals to angle EDC, why, vertically opposite angles are equal, and BD is equals to CD, BD is equals to CD, why, that is given thing. So by side angle side SAS criteria, we can say triangle ADB congruent triangle EDC by SAS, okay. Now these two triangles ADB and EDC are congruent, okay. So now we can say, second step I am taking here, now we can say angle or side, we can say BA is equals to EC, BA is equals to CE, why, CPCT, corresponding parts of congruent triangle, okay. AB and CE are the two sides of congruent triangle, corresponding sides, okay. So BA is equals to CE, okay. Now what we can say, BAD, angle BAD is equals to angle CED, this angle BAD is equals to CED are equal, okay, angle CED by again CPCT, the same reason. But what is given? BAD, angle BAD is equals to angle CAD, angle BAD is equals to CAD, that is given because they have told us AD is the bisector, AD is the bisector, here we have taken. So BAD is equal to CAD, so that is given thing, okay. If BAD and CAD are equal, if BAD and CED are equal, then we can say CAD, so angle CAD is equals to angle CED, angle CED. If you want, you can see here, this is first, second, and this is third, okay. So we can say BAD. So here we can give reason from first, second, and third, okay. See, this angle and this angle is equal, this angle and this angle is equal. So we can say this and this angle are equal. So angle CAD and CED are equal. That means CAE triangle, CAE is an isosceles triangle, isosceles triangle. CAE is isosceles triangle because base angles are equal. If base angles are equal, angles opposite of equals, sides opposite of equal angles are always equal. So we can say, so AC is equals to CE. AC and CE are equal. AC and CE are equal. But CE is equals to AB. CE is equals to AB. But CE is equals to AB from 1. Okay. CE is equals to AB. So we can say finally AB is equals to AC. AB is equals to AC. AB is equals to AC. If AB and AC are equal, then finally we can say triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle. Okay. So see, there are some reasons behind constructions. Okay. So if here, according with the help of given things, if we are not able to prove both the triangles are congruent with the help of any congruency criteria, then we need to do some constructions. Okay. So see carefully and do this in your notebook and solve this again and again. Okay. Okay, our first example, see here, in figure AB is equal to AC and DB is equal to DC, prove that angle ABD is equal to angle ACD. Okay, two figures are given. Okay, we have to give proof for both the figures. Here see, point D is in the internal section of triangle ABC, and here point D is the external section of triangle ABC. Okay, so first we will think about this. What is given in figure? AB is equal to AC. AB and AC are equal. AB and AC are equal. Okay, and DB and DC is also equal. DB and DC are equal. Okay, so now see here, if AB and AC are equal, this is definitely isosceles triangle. Okay, if this is isosceles triangle, the angles opposite of equal sides are same. Angles opposite of equal sides are same. So accordingly, we will prove here. See here, solution. What is given? See, AB in triangle ABC, AB is equal to AC. AB is equal to AC, which is given. Now we can say angle ABC is equals to angle ACB. ABC is equals to ACB. Okay. Why? Angles angles opposite of equal sides, angles opposite of equal sides are always same. So is ABC is equals to ACB. This is our first thing. We will say this is first one. Okay. Now we will think about triangle DBC. We will think about triangle DBC. So in triangle DBC, we have DB is equal to DC, which is given. DB is equal to DC is given. Okay. So triangle DBC is an isosceles triangle. Isosceles triangle. Triangle DBC is also an isosceles triangle. Okay. So we can say here angle DBC is equals to angle DCB. Okay. Angle DBC means this angle and this angle. Both the angles are same. Okay. So what is the reason? The same reason, angles opposite of equal sides, angles opposite of equal sides. Okay. So now we will say this is second one. Now what they have told us, angle ABD is equals to angle ACD. Okay. So see here, if from this ABC, if you will subtract DBC, what is going to remain? ABD, which they are asking. As same as angle ACB minus angle DCB, that time what is going to remain? ACD. Okay. So here we have to subtract this second from one. We have to subtract. So subtract second from first. Okay. So LHS from LHS. So angle ABC minus angle DBC. ABC minus DBC. Here angle ACB minus angle DCB. ACB minus angle DCB. Okay. So ABC minus DBC. What is going to remain? ABD. Angle ABD. This subtraction is angle ABD is equal to ACB minus DCB, means what is going to remain? ACD, angle ACD. Okay, which they are asking, ABD is equal to angle ACD. So this is the proof. Okay, this was about first figure. Now we are going to see about a second figure. Okay, here D is in the exterior of the triangle ABC. So how we will do? We will use the same thing. Here we have done subtraction. Now what we need to do? ABC plus DBC. That time what is going to remain? ABD. What is going to come? ABD. As same as here, this plus this is equals to ACD. Okay. So for second we will do by adding first and second. Okay. So LHS in LHS. So angle ABC plus angle DBC is equal to angle ACB plus angle DCB plus angle DCB. Okay. So ABC plus DBC means what is going to come? ABD. Angle ABD is equal to ACB plus DCB means what? ACD. Angle ACD. Okay. So that is about second figure. Understood? So very simple question it was. Okay. See here, our next problem is triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle with AB is equal to AC. Side BA is produced to D such that AB is equal to AD. Prove that angle BCD is a right angle. Okay. So see here, what is given? Triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle. First we are going to think about triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle with AB is equal to AC. AB and AC are equal. Okay. Isosceles triangle means obviously angle B and angle AC are equal. Okay. Afterwards, what is given? Side BA is produced. Side BA is produced 2D. Okay, in such a way such that AB is equal to AD. AB and AD are equal. This AB and AD are equal. Okay, which definitely triangle ACD is also an isosceles triangle. So here also we can say angle ACD and ADC are equal. Okay, and then we have to prove that angle BCD is a right angle. Angle BCD is right angle. This we have to prove right angle. Okay, so this is given information, and with the help of this we are going to prove triangle angle BCD is a right angle triangle. A right angle. Okay, so now first we will think about triangle ABC. In triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle. AB is equals to AC. AB and AC are equal. So we can say angle ABC, angle ABC plus angle ABC is equals to angle ACB. Okay, angle ABC, this angle and this angle is equal, are equal, because sides are equal, opposite sides are equal. So what reason we will write here? Angles opposite of equal sides. Okay, so that is the reason. So this we will say first one. Okay, now we will take this triangle ACD. In triangle ACD, what is AC is equals to AD. Okay, AC and AD are equal because AB and AC are equal, and we have constructed, or that is given, if BA is produced to point D in such a way AB is equal to AD. Okay, so here we can say AC and AD are equal. So triangle ACD is an isosceles triangle. So here also we can say angle ACD is equals to ADC, angle ADC. Okay, so this we will say second one. This angle is equals to this angle. Okay, so now what we can do, this is second one. If we will add both, first and second we will add, then what we will get? See, angle ABC plus angle ADC, means this angle and this angle we will add, and angle ACB plus ACD. ACB means this plus ACD means what is going to get? BCD. Okay, accordingly like that we are going to add. So here by adding first and second, so what I am taking here, ACB, this I am taking, angle ACB, ACB plus ACD, ACD, angle ACD is equal to, this we have taken, angle ABC plus angle ADC. Okay, this we have taken. Okay, first and second we need to add. So now see here, if you will see this ACB plus ACD means what? Sum of this and this angle, we will get this angle. So what is the name of that angle? Angle BCD. So this, instead of that, I am taking here angle BCD is equals to angle ABC plus ABC, or we can say DBC. Angle is going to remain same. Okay, DBC, I am saying here DBC. ABC means what? DBC. Okay, plus ADC, so I will say BDC. Okay, BDC. Okay, getting everybody? Why ABC we have taken DBC? ABC, here angle is important, so we can say ABC or DBC, anyhow it is same. Okay, so accordingly we have taken DBC plus BDC. Okay, so DBC means this angle, and BDC means this angle. Okay, this, if we are thinking about angle sum property of a triangle, then can we say here this angle plus angle C, whole angle, I am talking about whole angle, DCB is equals to 180 degree. okay. So suppose I want to use here angle sum property. Here two angles are here, two angles are, we have two angles. So if we'll add DCB in that, okay, in that, then we can write here 180 degree, we can write here 180 degree, understood. But we cannot add in the RHS, we need to add in the LHS, because both the sides should be same. So accordingly we are going to add. So by adding BD, BCD in both the sides, in both sides, okay. So here angle BCD is always already there, angle BCD plus this angle BCD is equals to angle DBC plus angle BDC, angle BDC, and which we are going to add plus angle BCD, okay. So BCD plus BCD, both the angles are same, so we can write here 2 times angle BCD, okay. DBC means what? DBC, I told you, this angle. BDC, this angle. And BCD means this angle. So can I write here, instead of this, sum of these three angles is equals to 180 degree, okay. So 2 we can say in that side, so angle BCD is equals to 180 divided by 2, so that is 90 degree, okay. So angle BCD is 90 degree, which they are asking, right angle means what? 90 degree, understood. So this way we need to show that triangle, that angle is 90 degree, okay. See here once again what we have done. Triangle ABC, AB is equal to AC was given, so ABC base angles are equal. Then ACD also right angle, isosceles triangle, so here also ACD is equals to ADC base angles. So we have added first and second, but while adding we need to take care this angle and this angle should be added, okay. So that way accordingly we have done adjustment. So the sum of this is BCD, and this angle, two angles are there out of three angles, two angles we have, so one more angle we have added in both the sides, BCD here also and here also. So 2 times BCD, and the sum of these 3 is 180 degree. So 2 will go that side, 180 divided by 2 is equals to 90 degree. Okay, thank you.